previously on the TapChap show.
Are you ready? Jesus! Are you ready to review a game so bad and it makes other bad games piss themselves in fear?
Sure.
Good. Cause it needs to be terminated.
Oh no.
What the fuck do you want?
Jesus c***.
Watch your language, mister.
You don't call me mister. Are you okay? It's been months since your last review.
Yeah, I'm fucking dandy.
Are you sure? How many fingers am I holding up?
How the fuck am I supposed to see your fingers?
Good, you passed the test.
What test?
Snap out of it!
Oh, what was that for?
Do you know how many children are starving in Africa right now?
What the fuck are you talking about?
When I was 12 years old, I learned to tie my shoes, and so should you, damn it!
Listen, you need to calm down, because you're not making any goddamn sense.
And furthermore,
nobody puts baby in the corner!
I love the smell.
I'm living in a cartoon.
One time we had a hill bomb for 12 hours. When it was all over, I walked up. I didn't find one of them. Not one stinking dink body. The smell. You know that gasoline smell? The whole hill smelled like victory. Someday, this war is gonna end.
Look, if I do this review, will you start making sense again?
Blueberries!
Oh, for fuck's sake! Well, it's time to do my first review. It's been a long time coming, hasn't it?
Yeah, you tell them, TapChap.
Shut the fuck up, Kevin. This is Terminator Salvation.
So a few years ago, the executives at Warner Bros. Decided to take a shitload of
cocaine
and created the idea to make a fourth movie in the Terminator series called Salvation. They fixed a $2 million budget and hired MCG to direct it, who was the director behind such classics as Charlie's Angels, This Means War, and the pilot episode for the TV show Shuck. And for the cast of the movie, they decided to hire such amazing actors as Batman, Clumsy Smurf, and that blue dude from Avatar. And as for the writers, they hired some dudes who worked on the movie Catwoman. Brilliant. But you might be wondering where Arnold Schwarzenegger is. Well, he was busy jerking off at the gym.
Like, getting the feeling of coming in the gym, I'm getting the feeling of coming at home.
And so, in 2009, the movie finally hit theaters and it got incredibly positive and cheering reviews such as, meh. Even Arnold Schwarzenegger himself said, and I quote,
"It sucked."
But I don't know where all the hatred comes from. Like, was it really that bad? I mean, Arnie even got a CGI version of himself. What the fuck is that?
Fuck you, asshole.
And because it was such a hit, that of course meant it had to have its own game.
That's right, people. That means that this right here is a movie licensed video game.
Developed by the wonderfully Swedish people over at the now defunct Grin Studios, famous for such brilliant titles as Wanted, Weapons of Fate, Bionic Commando, and Balls, I mean Ballistic. Released merely 2 days before the movie itself, all the kiddies at home got the chance to play Terminator Salvation for their precious game consoles. And it was total shit. Why, you ask?
Well, let's take a look.
So the game starts off in the post-apocalyptic future of the year 2000 and something. And we see that the Terminators have taken over the world as our main character is bitching about some bullshit.
I try and remember the world the way it used to be, but it gets harder every day.
I'm acting. But as you can hear, Christian Bale didn't want to lend his voice or face into this game. And you can imagine all the kids at home playing this game being like,
"Who the fuck's that? That's not Christian Halle Berry."
It was probably because Christian Bale could predict that a movie-licensed video game would suck ass, so he didn't want to have anything to do with it. Or maybe the folks at Grin Studios were just fucking terrified of him.
In the middle of a scene? Then why the fuck are you walking right through? Like this in the background. What the fuck is it with you?
So back to the game. We can see our main character look over the scene and, hey look, there's a Disney castle. I know Disney would take over the world somehow, but this is just wrong. Terminator isn't even a Disney movie, for crying out loud. Well, at least not for now.
I'm looking at you, Marvel and Lucasfilms.
What?
Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, I regret this decision quite immediately. And after all those cutscenes, we finally jump into the actual gameplay, and it's bland. Just as bland as this piece of cheddar, which is not real fucking cheese, by the way. I mean, the controls are barely responsive and it feels very light. There's no real weight to it. Plus, it feels like I'm just sliding on ice. Like Bambi, in the movie Bambi.
Which is a Disney movie. Oh my god, it all comes together!
Come on, Tad, but that doesn't mean anything.
Or does it?
No, it doesn't.
Are you sure? Okay, maybe you're right.
And you know, for a person who was nearly hit by a chopper, he looks fucking great. It's almost like the chopper never existed at all. And speaking of choppers, this game really reminds me of another game called Gears of War.
What the hell does choppers have to do with Gears of War?
Shut the fuck up and let me explain. Just look at the covering system. It looks like it was ripped straight out from the Gears of War games, just really poorly. And you know a game is fucking excellent when it steals stuff from other actually pretty good games and is still a piece of shit.
You're not looking good, Terminator Salvation.
Terminator Salvation? More like Terminator Salad!
What does that even mean?
I don't know, it makes more sense to get worse than related to middle fucking shoppers.
Touché, Kevin. Touché.
Yeah, look at him go! Dodge those, whatever the hell those are supposed to be. Bullets? Lasers? Cats? The fuck do I know?
And after all that just outstanding gameplay, we move on to our next section and...
This way, let's go.
Video games!
You know a game is just brilliant when it uses its in-game engine for its cutscenes. And this is the outcome. You remember those cutscenes from the start? Yeah, that's pretty much the only part of the game that has any quote-unquote effort put into it. After that, it's just fuck all. We're doing it in-game. What could go wrong? Yeah, this.
You're tearing me apart, Terminator Salvation.
And after that, we move on in the game and...
Look, it's a cute tiny skull. He's lying there.
Dead.
Looks like somebody lost their head. Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you all so much. And also, what's the deal with Jeff Goldblum's acting in Jurassic Park The Lost Worlds?
Sarah!
And just look at this beautiful cutscene.
Yeah, we know. It won't take long to reach the hotel.
Have you seen how many wasps and spiders are out there?
Metal Gear Solid 4 Guns of the Patriots can't suck it! And how can we only fight fucking wasps and spiders? I thought we were going up against, oh I don't know, fucking Terminators? Yeah, that's not going to help, guys. This is like the most inappropriate time to play the Terminator theme, you know, when we're fighting fucking wasps and spiders!
Okay, now calm your tits, Kevin. So after killing a bunch of wasps and spiders, we're greeted to the most epic fucking loading screen in a video game ever. Just look at its beauty. Step aside, loading screens in Sonic 06. You just got served. And also... What was that sound we heard just before the loading screen? And then we finally step into our first boss fight, which is a giant ass HK.
Also known as a hungry crocodile, with a K.
Let's do this, baby.
Did John Connor just turn into a teenage girl lying on his bed talking on the phone to his girlfriends?
Oh my god, Tiffany, you will not believe what just happened today. No. I got my first period and it tasted just wonderful.
Okay, motherfucker. This time, it's personal. Hygiene!
Yeah!
Endo! My god, is that a Terminator?
Peters!
Praise Jesus, it's a fucking Terminator!
How about you suck my dick?
Oh Jesus, you nasty motherfucker, come here!
Wait, is he driving a fucking car?
Well, it is a free country.
Oh yeah, I suppose. Oh, there he goes. Well, that was fun.
I give that one Terminator 9 out of 10 blenders. Give him applause, everyone!
So one boring turret section later, it seems like they've met a dead end, and they have to find a way around this mess.
Alright, everyone underground, let's go, people.
Wait, did he even move his fucking mouth while speaking?
Alright, everyone underground, let's go, people.
No, he didn't. Oh well, that's one terrific ventriloquism act you got going there, whoever you are. As a matter of fact, I can do that too.
Hello guys, let's fucking lead us!
And then we move on to chapter 2. Thank heaven. And thank heaven indeed. Look at those beautiful textures. It's so real. It's almost like I can reach out and touch it.
TapChap!
Jesus!
Control yourself.
Okay.
Okay, so what happens next in this fucking game?
Marks, take cover!
How could this happen to me? I made my mistakes. The moral terrain. The natural sign of something real. I'm sick of this life. I just wanna scream. How could this happen to me?
Oh no, not that guy!
Whoever he was, Egoraptor? Was that Egoraptor?
Also, that is like the best way to die. Just go limp like you just don't care. You know? Like, Limp Bizkit.
Hello, friend. Can I play with you, Gap? Oh no, why did you do that? I thought we were friends.
Fuck you, I'm John Connor.
What the fuck did you do to Jerry? You monster! Oh god!
Fuck you. I'm John Connor.
Finally.
Something's wrong. Where is everyone?
Maybe we're too late and missed the evac.
Oh well, they missed the evac. They're fucked. Everyone's fucked. Dizzy took over the world and killed everyone. All the penguins, red pandas, cats, dogs, rabbits, squirrels, chinchillas, Bubsy, Bubsy 3D, Spyro the Dragon, Son Goku, Jennifer Lawrence, Danny DeVito, Barry White from the Golden Girls, Ace the Gamer Dude, Mr. Mime, way too many other characters to mention, but this joke is going on for way too long, so I'm gonna have to stop before I kill myself.
Okay, so maybe that's not the end, but I really can't take much more of this.
Me neither.
Shut the fuck up, Kevin. The graphics are very lackluster. Textures look like they were ported from an old PS2 game. The environments look dull and very pixelated. They don't look very realistic and they seem to just be copy and pasted everywhere. And for an Xbox 360 game, that's just sad. I mean, they're not terrible, but more effort could have been put into the game's presentation. Graphics like these really make it apparent when a game is just rushed out the door to make a quick buck off a blockbuster movie. The different stages have no imagination whatsoever. Grin Studios just took the idea of a destroyed city and roll with it. They all seem very generic, and you would never tell if you were at the start or the end of the game if someone just handed you the controller at any point. Not very creative. Look at Metal Gear Solid, where the player is confined on an island, stuck in this huge facility with tight hallways and cramped office spaces, but there are many different unique areas throughout the facility to keep things interesting for the player, like the outdoor area with the landmines, or the container room where you fight Raven. They kept the theme to the same kind of environments, but also managed to keep things
fresh.
I also noticed that Terminator Salvation has this kind of dark grey or green tint over everything. Obviously, trying to make the game look more post-apocalyptic, but it doesn't seem to add to the game's aesthetics at all. Gameplay is very, very repetitive and underwhelming. It just seems like the same old thing over and over again. Fight robots, move forward, fight robots, move forward, etc, etc. Without adding much variety into the gameplay. Throughout the whole game, you're forced to fight wasps and spiders with very little change. Wasps are easy to kill, but can be annoying as fuck to fight. With the spiders, they try to change up the gameplay by forcing you to flank them to destroy them, but that's far too easy to do, so there's no challenge. I know later on at some point you start to fight actual Terminators, but they work the same way as the spiders, you have to get behind them to destroy them. The combat is just dry as cardboard, and the cover system is really odd. It takes forever to move from cover to cover because of how badly it was programmed, and there's only like 3 weapons to choose from here and there. And they all handle the same exact way. None of the guns feel different from the other. You don't even feel like you're doing any damage with them. You get the idea that you're firing pellets at the robots. The controls feel floaty, and they seem very sluggish as you play the game. Weapon control is slow and awkward. And even John himself seems to just slide along the ground. Animations are awkward and hilarious to look at. When John runs, he looks weightless. Comparing that to, let's say, Joel in The Last of Us, where you can physically see his weight shifting from leg to leg as he runs. But here, there's none of that. And in the cutscenes, all the characters look like animatronics from a theme park. They're all so stiff looking. Hell, some characters don't even open their mouths. Probably because they use the in-game engine to create these sloppy cutscenes. Music-wise, to be honest, it almost doesn't seem like it's even there as you're playing. It's so monotonous and boring that it just slips away under all the other game sounds and you forget it even exists. The only time it's even noticeable is when the so-called remix of the Terminator theme plays during some of the parts of the game, but it's always inappropriate for the situation it's in. The story is just boring. I don't know what's supposed to be even happening half the time. It doesn't suck you in and make you want to invest time into it. All I can gather is they're trying to make it to some evac point, but after that it's just hazy. And for a game called Terminator Salvation, it doesn't even follow the movie's story. The story is actually set between Terminator 3 and Salvation. So why is the game even called Terminator Salvation? Every time I attempt to play this game, I try as hard as I can to pay attention to the story. It's just so dull and boring that it's next to impossible to keep track. And the bland characters doesn't help either. They're just so out of place and unlikable that you wouldn't even want to make a connection with these characters. I mean, do we really even care about these characters? I guess John Connor's important to the whole Terminator story, but the way he's played in the game makes him seem so unimportant and as generic as a main story character can get. I don't care about who these people are or what their middle names are, and that's characters done wrong. In games like The Last of Us, The Walking Dead, and even fucking Putt-Putt Adventures, we form somewhat of a connection with these amazing characters through great writing and fantastic voice acting. That's how we make a connection, thus begin to care about them. And I can, by fact, tell you that Putt-Putt's middle name is Jeremy. And speaking of voice acting, the voice acting in this game is pretty damn horrible. None of the actors sound invested into this game whatsoever. They sound like they just came into work every day half asleep and said their lines just to get their paycheck, and then go home and eat Pop-Tarts for the rest of the day. And the sad thing is that Nolan North, a pretty fucking fantastic voice actor who played Nathan Drake, Desmond Miles, and fucking Deadpool is in this game. Why, Nolan? Why?
So to sum it up, this game is pretty awful, and nobody should buy a copy of this. Open up the case, put it in their console, and play this horrendous piece of shit that the developers dared to call a video game. What do you think, Kevin?
Oh, sorry, I wasn't paying any attention to what you were saying. I was playing some Puzzle and Dragon Z. What were you saying again?
Oh, you motherfucker!
Hey, what's going on, guys? It is TapChap here, and if you made it this far in the video, well, guess what? You guys are freaking awesome. You made it through this silly little video of us rambling about Terminator Salvation. A huge, huge thank you to my buddy Kevin, who not only lended his voice and his beautiful face to this video, but also helped co-write the script for this video, and even helped co-edit the video. This first review wouldn't have been possible without him. On the screen you can see there are two videos. If you click either two of the videos on screen, one will take you to Kevin's channel where you can see many of his other zany and wacky reviews or other videos on his channel, and the other one will bring you to my first top 10 list video, which is my personal favorite top 10 video game theme songs. But if you enjoyed this review and you want to see more, how about you go ahead and leave a like and maybe hit the subscribe button if you want to see more of these reviews on this channel, and don't forget to share it with your friends and on Facebook and Twitter. Hope to see you around soon. So thank you all for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye bye.
The smell. You know that gasoline smell? The whole smell. Shit! I'm doing this all, you know, by memory. You know that gasoline smell? The whole hill smell. Fuck. Shit. I love the smell of napalm in the morning. You know what? I love the smell of napalm in the morning. You know, one time, someday, this war is gonna end.
Nailed it. That was a long fucking take, man. Jesus.
I don't know. This must have a chance to get worse. Real fucking little shit.
Do you even like salad?
Nope. Fucking related to salads. Fuck. Fucking salads. Why did I say salads? Fucking choppers. Motherfucker. Worse blades.
I give that one Terminator 9 out of 10 blenders. Give him applause, everyone. Whoa, I'm actually playing this game. I did not hit her, it's bullshit! I didn't hit her, I did not! Oh, hi, Mark. But Lisa, you're a part of my life! And Tommy Wiseau, from the room. Yeah.
Jesus Christ, I'm sweating my ass off in this shit.